Everybody, it's Sunday, and I'm back home after a long bus drive. Yeah, I had to take the bus home because apparently the train was all booked up until like Tuesday or Wednesday or something, and even the bad train, the one that I took earlier, that took me like forever and 7 hours and shit, so I had to take the bus, and the bus driver has jacked up the prices, so I had to pay a lot to come back home. But there was no other choice. It was either that or stay up there for a couple more days. And I was homesick. I wanted to get home ready. So I get off the bus and I come over here. My husband is... I thought he was at work. And so it surprised me that he came downstairs. And he got my suitcase. Now, my suitcase is... I was really, really tired last night. I mean, you can't imagine how tired I was. I was so tired, I didn't even finish drinking all the wine. Now, that's a damn... That's how tired I am, because that wine bottle would be gone. So, I was so exhausted. And I had to pack. And not only pack, but, like, make room for all the stuff that I had to take. Because my daughter got, like, a bunch of toys. And each toy she got had like 25 pieces to it. So, oh my god. And plus my sister gave me some stuff. And so I had a couple bags of extra stuff. And how am I going to fit it? You know, the thing is that if I'm going on the little bus only has so much room for the luggage, you know. And I don't want the guy charging me extra. So my sister helped me pack. She folded the clothes. She did like the thing where she rolls up the clothes and put, you know, because I don't do that. I just throw everything in the bag and, you know, whatever, you know. But she rolled up all the clothes and like nice little burritos and put them in my suitcase. And then she squished everything in there. Everything fit nice and neat. It reminded me of, you know, in the cartoons where like they throw everything in the closet and then the door is like pulsating, like you don't want to open it because the minute you open it, everything's just gonna spill right at you. Yeah, my luggage was like that. It was only for show. If you were to open that thing, it would just erupt with a bunch of stuff. So I didn't go on those bags for nothing. I just opened them now. It's a big old mess down there. My cats are sleeping on my clothes. So my luggage is really heavy. Now, the bus driver is always a middle-aged man, like in late 50s. Never fails. I once had one that was 70. And he was lifting up the luggage. But my luggage wasn't heavy then. So this guy was all smiles until he picked up my luggage. And then he gave me the most evil look I've ever seen. At 6 a.m., he looked at me. Like, what do you have in here? Who have you decapitated and are now smuggling back to Miami? I think I even caught him taking a whiff of my bag. Like, is there blood in here? So, he finally, after he, like, pulled his back out, trying to put my luggage on the suitcase. I mean, my luggage on the bus, he finally did that. So, we were on our way. It didn't feel that long to me today because I slept during the first half of the trip. And then we ended up in, I think it was, St. Lucie or St. Cloud, one of the two. I think St. Lucie. And whatever, but it was like the halfway mark to get to Miami. And so it's a rest stop that we ended up at. And I had to make a line and be in the line for like 5 minutes just to get coffee. And I got my kid some sugar because she was just falling asleep. And so, yeah, I got the coffee finally. So I'm walking out of the rest area, right? And to my right, I noticed they have vending machines. So I look and there's actually a Best Buy vending machine in the freaking rest area. Can you believe that? They had everything in there. They had freaking the games and iPods and cameras and... My God, I could not believe that. And what was worse is that the stupid machine kept spitting out my wrinkled dollar, so I couldn't get anything out of the machine. But anyways, yeah, so the ride was nice home. I get home, my husband is here. My husband is all smiles until he has to drag those suitcases up 3 flights of stairs. But he was still happy. He gave me the biggest bear hug ever. He gave my daughter hugs and kisses. And then he told me, "Wow, you look like you didn't gain that much weight this time." Always the sensitive guy. My God, he's just so sensitive. So anyways, I opened my suitcase, everything spilled out. Now it's a big old mess here. I don't want to clean, folks. I don't want to do a thing. I hate that I smoke so much on vacation, because now I feel like I want to smoke, like, really bad. And I have things to smoke, but I should not be smoking, because that's the last thing I need, is to pick up that smoking habit again. And, but I'm going to try my best not to do that, so I'm going to stick to alcohol instead. So, my kid got a bunch of gifts. My husband got her a Nintendo DSi, got her a portable DVD player, which, thank Christ, because now she can be quiet in the car and just listen to the headphones and watch whatever the heck she watches, and that's it. He got her like a bunch of games for her Leapfrog and all that, so she is exhausted. Right now she's watching TV, and God, I don't want to clean. I want to put up my Christmas tree today. I don't have a grand extravagant tree. I have a little tree, so that should take all of 5 minutes. Unless I procrastinate, then it should take about half an hour. We have a fish now in the house. The fish is a betta that my sister bought me. And I had to take the fish on the bus, and everyone's fascinated with the fish. First they start being fascinated by the fish, then they get near the fish and smell the funk, you know, of like fish water. Especially betta water, which stinks like fucking sewer. And then they don't want to look at the fish anymore. So, my sister got us a fish, or my daughter rather, and it's a little blue betta. It's not a regular betta, it's actually a crown tail betta. Fancy. It's it looks like a betta with, it looks like a cross between a betta and like a cockatoo. It looks like as though the betta stuck his fin in the electrical outlet and everything just spilled out. That's what he looks like. I put him in the bowl already. He has pink rocks, and his house is very feminine. So my fish is a cross dresser. I don't know. He's okay, I guess. I mean, he's floating to the top of the bowl, right? But they all do that, don't they? Like, when they want air and stuff, they just, like, lay on their side and, you know, like, taking a break, right? So, he's cool. He'll be okay. So, what else? I am at 111. I am pissed. I'm pissed. Why am I pissed? I am pissed because I binge and purge while I was away, and I was lazy and binge and purging. I was lazy and binge and purging because I don't want my nephews to hear me purging, you know. And I don't want my sister's husband to hear me purging because, even though he knows what I do, but still, you don't want to hear that, or you don't want to hear somebody tell you, oh, don't do that in my house or something, you know. I don't want a lecture, you know. So I got sloppy and lazy and binging and purging, and now I'm paying the price. So, God, I don't know. I had two good days, though, where I ate and I didn't purge. That contributed to the gain, but it also contributed to, making me feel a little bit better, because I gave my body, you know, some nourishment. I gave my body something other than abuse, so I'm not so pissed about that. I'm just pissed about the binge and purging part. I think I could have, like, not done that, you know, or tried my hardest if I really wanted to, you know, but it was just hard, you know. So I haven't taken my meds in 3 days. That's not good. I've taken them today though, but I've been slacking not taking them because I've been taking like the diet pills and the water pills and stuff. So, I mean, I tend to either do one thing or the other. If I'm gonna do something positive, then I'm gonna stick to the positivity. But if I'm gonna go negative, then I usually go all out. So, that's my problem. My sister sent me home with party supplies. Most of them I've just already taken. So I got laxatives here. I've taken all of but five. I have green tea pills that she gave me. I don't like drinking green tea. It tastes gross to me, so I'd rather take the pills. And I also have three different types of water pills. So, yeah, party supplies for me. I have six laxative bottles in my refrigerator right now. I feel like a big part of me that wants all this weight off, like drastically off, you know, but I don't want to look sick. I feel good right now that I don't look sick. I'm at a decent weight. These things should make me happy, but they don't. And I hate that about the eating disorder. I hate that I cannot find a fucking balance. Oh, where I could just maintain and be happy. I give myself a point to maintain too. And then I get so dangerously close to the maintaining weight, like the end of the spectrum, you know. And I just panic. And instead of being happy or saying, well, it could be worse or this is not that bad, I look back to how far I've fallen originally, and then it's just a game of catch up. So I wish that I didn't feel like that with the eating disorder. I wish that I could just be happy, you know, but I don't think that's possible. I don't know what will make me happy. I don't think that there is a specific weight, a number that will do that. So I have to, when I have time, research for another therapist. I think I have to do that, because when I don't go to therapy this Tuesday, I'm going to be incredibly depressed, let me tell you. I'm going to really feel that shit, because I feel like, I don't like quitting, and I don't like giving up. Those are two things I don't like to do, and I feel like I did that this time with the therapist. I feel like I just quit, and I didn't give it a second thought. And that decision is going to weigh on me heavily, so I think I need to try to find another therapist and give it a shot. I don't know about telling about the eating disorder yet. God, I really want to, I do, but I just don't want someone to give me an ultimatum, you know, or demand things of me and tell me, you have to stop, or you do this or else this. Like, I don't want that. I'm an adult, and yes, I make childish decisions at times concerning my health. My judgment is off. But I don't want someone to put me in that position where it's all or nothing, you know. I don't want to get to that point. And that's my fear with therapy. Telling a therapist about the eating disorder. Or telling a doctor even. And the other way that it could go is telling a doctor or therapist, I have an eating disorder. And they tell me, no, you don't have an eating disorder. And then they tell me I'm not sick enough. That it's impossible or something. And that... And then, like, what is the point, you know? So, that's my problem. But I think, no, I don't think. I know. I know that my eating disorder is what is stopping me from everything. It is hindering me from moving forward. It wants me to stay stuck in this position where I'm constantly doubting everything and everyone. And so I can continue to be sick and continue to do the behaviors and continue to lose weight until I do feel sick, because I don't feel sick. I don't feel sick. I don't look sick. I don't think I look thin enough to be considered as if I have an eating disorder. So I think that because I'm not those things, kind of like a sign, like saying, you know, keep going, you know, you're gonna be okay, just keep going, just a little bit more, a little bit more, a little bit more. And that's the bad part about this thing, is that your perception is off a lot. So Oh God, I don't know. I just feel like I have a bunch of weight on my shoulders right now. I have a lot coming up. My husband has to leave in January. Really leave, like bye. And I have to have some kind of income by then. I don't know what I will be doing to get money, but I have to get money. Because if not, he will use that as an excuse to try to weasel his way back in my life and stay put. And I can't have that. I can't. So, I gotta find a job. ASAP. I spoke to the boy last night. You know, he's happy that we hung out at least. We left things open. We're gonna be friends. I can't do long distance. He did long distance last time, and his girl and him broke up because of that. With me particularly, I can't do long distance because I thought about it at first, and I thought that I wouldn't mind, but the more I think about it, I would mind. I am very greedy. I am, especially when it comes to someone that I really care about. I just want that person all the time. I want to be with them. I don't know if that's clingy or neurotic even, but that's me. I just want to consume that person. So being away from them, even if it's 4 hours away, that's still a lot, you know, for me. I can't have someone that's not gonna be there for me, because not only will it hurt me incredibly, I'll be heartbroken because I would just long for this person so much. I would start losing interest. I don't know why, but out of sight is out of mind with me. The longer I'm not around you, the more I just start forgetting about you. I don't know if that's like a coping thing, but I noticed that I tend to get over stuff. I mean, even horrible, life-changing, horror story kind of shit. I tend to get over it the more the years go by, the more the days go by, the more time, and the more the gap gets bigger. The more I don't care, you know? I don't care. So I don't want that to happen in this case. I think that it's better to just leave things the way they are and just, you know, we can hang out when I come back to see my sister and leave it like that, you know? I'm not ready for, to uproot my life and move somewhere. I'm not ready for living with someone that I don't really, really know and who may have good intentions, but you know what? I have a kid and, you know, you gotta take both of us. And also, I don't think I'm ready for having another guy around my kid, you know, or trying to be like a father figure to my kid, because my kid already has a dad, you know, so it's a big can of worms, and I don't think I'm ready for that. I think I need to get my head out the clouds a little bit and focus on what's down here better. So yeah, so things are gonna be okay between us. We're just gonna keep talking or whatever, but no hard feelings. But I just can't give him what he wants right now. So what else? I think that's it. I have to start cleaning. I'm gonna put the iTunes as loud as I can and try to focus on the task at hand and not check what's on the DVR and not get online or other things. So I think that's it. I will talk to you guys again next week. I'm gonna blog during the week. Oh God, and that's it. So bye everybody, hope you're all doing well. Goodbye.